Hey y'all, here's a quick video on how I use the Epson V550 and V800 scanners to scan all my negatives. First off, you're going to want to clean off the dust from your negatives using a blower or an air compressor. It's important to keep your film as flat as possible, so I use ANR glass, which is anti-Newton ring glass, to avoid Newton rings and maintain a very flat negative. The 120 ANR glass for the V550 will work with 35mm and 120 film. If you're using the stock holder for the V550, I highly suggest that you use the supplied little card to hold the film flat. I actually found that my Epson V550 scanner scanned really well with the emulsion side directly down on the glass. Using your scanning program, you'll select the area on the negative that you want to scan and go to Levels Adjustment. Click the Highlight Dropper tool and find a highlight area that is white or close to white. Try different highlight areas until you find one that gives you a proper exposure and color balance for the scene. Be sure to select all if you're scanning multiple photos. Now you'll click Scan, choose the folder where you want to put your photo, name the photo, and it's best to scan it as a TIFF if you can, because this will yield a much higher quality file to work from in Photoshop or Lightroom. When scanning instant film, I'll dust the shot off and then set it onto the glass, and I'll put something in between the lid and the scanning bed to prevent it from smashing the shot down too much, and this will help prevent Newton rings. The rest of the software process is roughly the same. You'll select the area of the photograph and then go to Levels Adjustment and use the Droppers tool on the white border of your photograph in order to exposure and color balance your photograph. The ANR glass and scanning unit that I'm using for the V800 comes from betterscanning.com. I highly suggest this holder, it's worked really well for me. What I'll do with the V800 is tape the negatives down in order to achieve a very flat negative. You'll also want to be sure that you adjust the focus height of your scanner, and you'll see in these examples here that the focus height definitely makes a difference in the sharpness of your scan. Notice the difference in the detail on the lens in this photograph. Stay tuned for more. Think more, shoot less.